Spike added to this movie the swagger of the DAP.
Let me give you some power.
Let me see if I can remember this.
Come on, you got it.
DAP is an acronym for dignity and pride, and it's a very important handshake that the brothers during the Vietnam War had that showed fraternity, brotherhood, showed togetherness. It was more than a greeting, more than a handshake. It was a confirmation of not only brotherhood, but survival.
During the Vietnam War, Black combat troops comprised a little over a third of the troops that were stationed going into action. Those young Black men were coming from urban environments and cities that were rebelling against oppression, systemic racism, over-policing, police brutality, lack of employment, active and blatant discrimination. So we're in the midst of the burgeoning Black Power movement. The slogan itself, "Say it loud, I'm Black and I'm proud," represented the spirit and energy of this new sense of pride and identity.
When we got to Vietnam, Black folk got into this hyper solidarity, and it was like me and you, brother, against the world.
You got me?
This would be a DAP. This is also considered a DAP.
I'm not above you. You're not above me. We're side by side, together. And so from there, the bloods would lock, and one head would be here, my head would be here, meaning I got your back, you've got mine.
We all felt like it was bringing us together, giving us pride, giving us courage, and uniting us.
It was an expression of Blackness. It was performative.
That bond Vietnam vets had continued when they were back in the States. And they needed that bond because of the hostilities that existed in America toward Vietnam veterans, where they could express themselves fully was really back home in the Black community. Once it got back home, then it just went in all different directions.
So if you could break down a timeline, you could say the Vietnam War going down into the Black Panthers, then the Black Movies, then we have the Crips, then we have the Bloods, then we have Lion Kings, and then handshakes and DAP lines come in all different styles and different meanings and reputation. So each symbol that you can make with your hand has a significance as you connect with your brother.
There's always a message behind it.
So it's always a message and a calling and a sign.
The guys in New York and the guys in Miami or Chicago, Houston, they all had a different DAP. So when a guy walked up to you and threw his fist up, he expected for you to give him your DAP. He'll open his hand, close his fist, but you give him your DAP. And then in return, you give him back your DAP. So that rhythm was a part of the DAP expression.
If you have a chance to look at an NBA game from the 1960s, it is very subdued. But what you got primarily when players are introduced or they greet each other on the court, it is not necessarily with a handshake. It is with sort of a double flap of the hands. That's a form of the DAP. And as Black culture began to impact American society in the 70s and 80s, what becomes popular? The high five. What becomes even more popular is, especially for basketball players, is that they jump and give the high five. And then it continued to evolve with all these things that outside of sport impacting the athletes themselves. And of course, the popularity of the NBA began to just spread throughout.
Well, you can see the DAP in a lot of places. I don't know if a lot of the younger generation understand the DAP, but if you look at people meeting on the street, there's a kind of a greeting. It's a silent way of saying, how are you? I love you, and we are brothers.
Right now in our coronavirus and our protesting, a lot of the young folks are putting up the power fist. We started the power fist back in 1960. The power fist is a symbol. Yeah. Black Lives Matter is doing a symbol of the DAP.
Black Lives Matter! Black Lives Matter!
When Barack was nominated, and he and Michelle gave the fist pump, and I said, they dapping right here. And I don't talk with some of my Vietnam vet friends, and I said, did you see Barack Obama and his wife dapping? And it was like, yeah. You know, so it's just an affirmation of the power of Black culture and how it has permeated American society, even in the White House. And I said, here you have a president of the United States dapping. What else is gonna happen? But it's just a phenomenal thing.
I'm gonna teach you that.
As an adult man, I dap up my son. My son's 8 years old. I mean, I have a personal dap. And you can see in his eyes that he's like, he feels special because I don't dap nobody else with dap. I gotta dap just for him. DAP is like a consolement, you know. It's a positive, right. A feeling internally to know that you're welcome somewhere, that you're wanted somewhere, that someone is thinking about you, that you're a part of something bigger than what you're feeling in the moment.
What we sincerely ask is that understand the depth and the roots that the DAP draws from, that these very amazing gestures of Black culture represent really come from very deep places. They really represent something that's profound and wonderful, but should be honored and revered and sincerely taken and shared. You know, it's not something that's just like, if you're not Black, you can't adapt, but it's something that, if you are gonna adapt, it has to come from a place of love, of solidarity, of recognition of humanity.
Nice.